greetings to the viewers. Myself R. Karthikeyan, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Dr. NGP Institute of Technology, Coimbatore. In this video lecture, we will going to discuss about the Watt Governor. Watt Governor is a governor. It is a subtype of a centrifugal governor. And the purpose of a governor is to regulate the fuel supply of an engine. When fuel supply of an engine is regulated, we can regulate the speed of an engine. Okay. This is a skeleton of a Watt governor. It has a two upper arm, which is called as arms, two lower arms, sometimes we call it as legs. Okay. When upper arm and lower arm is connected with the ball, it has some weight, mass. Okay. There will be a tension between a ball and the point P, upper point O. Okay. This segment, this parameter called height, when speed of an engine increases, okay, this sleeve will move upward, the height of the governor will reduce. When speed of an engine decreases, the height of a governor will increase. Okay, when sleeve goes up, the height value will be low. When sleeve comes down, the height value will be high. Okay, these are the some of the components of the Watt governor. It consists of a mass of a ball. Okay, the weight of the mass. W is weight of the ball, it's in Newton. Next, omega is the angular velocity of the arm. Next one, R is the radius of path rotation, which indicates the from central axis to the ball. Okay, it is the distance between this ball and the axis. Okay. Then FC is centrifugal force acting over the ball. Okay, when ball rotates, it will create a centrifugal force. Then H component will be the height of the governor. As I explained earlier, the height of the governor will increase or decrease, depends upon the speed of an engine. Next component is tension. Tension which acts in the upper arm. Okay, when a governor rotates, there will be tension between upper arm, the point O and FC. Okay. Now we will see how to calculate the height of an engine. There will be a derivation by taking a movement at point O. Moment of O. Okay. When arms rotates, there will be two kind of force. One is FC, another one is height. Okay. There will be a this equation becomes FC into H, which is equal to W into R. W is the weight of the ball. Okay, which acts downwards. W into R. R is the distance between axis and then ball. Okay, we know the formula for centrifugal force. FC equal to m omega square r. Then this equation becomes m omega square r into h equal to, we know that W equal to m into g, m dot g into r. From this equation, the same component will get cancelled. This m and m will get cancelled. R becomes cancelled. So the final equation will be h equal to g divided by omega square. Okay. We know that omega is angular velocity of an arm about the axis. Then H is the height of a governor. G is an acceleration due to gravity. Our ultimate aim of is Watt governor is to calculate the height of the governor, because the speed of an engine will vary. Okay, when you give a maximum speed, we will the height of engine will vary, height of the governor will vary. When it rotates in a minimum speed, the height of the governor will vary. Okay, we know the value of G is 9.81. We know the formula for acceleration, angular velocity, that is 2 pi n divided by 60. Finally, it becomes h equal to